Hello everybody, I am GB the Hooligan and I'm the caster of today, and I will be casting a game for you between in the south Zerg as the Austere, and he immediately picked Jaeger Infantry Doctrine. And in the north we have RTN Hector, who's playing as the British forces. He can pick from Royal Engineer Regiment, Advanced Emplacement Regiment and Special Weapons Regiment. And straight away we can see a very interesting cast, or interesting strategy. We see that our Austere player, Zerg, is going for two MGs into another Pioneer. That's interesting. We'll see how that works out in the rest of the game. Normal build orders from Hector. Both players are going for their fuse straight away. We've got our first little engagement over here. Another Vickers from Hector as well. Not much interesting going on. I wouldn't be surprised if Sir goes for a quick tack up to Tier 2, maybe some quick scout cars will be good against British forces. And the players, as you've seen, are playing on Minsk pockets. It's a 2v2 map originally, but it's also in the 1v1 map pool. I'll put down the sound a little bit. But yeah, I haven't played this map in 1v1 a lot. I think I've, in my 100 games as a 1v1 player, maybe I've played it twice. But yeah, we'll see how this works out. I think it's a decent map in 1v1. It's pretty long, you can't really flank much. But in 1v1 it might be good. Good that Hector set up his Vickers straight away to protect his fume. Not much else going on. Another HMG from Zerg. Heavy HMG play. Interesting. Hector already upgrades to the platoon command post. Will he be going for Bovers or armored car? I mean, it's interesting. Also funny, Hector has the munition that's normally for the south side, and Zerg has the munition that's normally for the north side. That's funny. Good that Hector upgraded his infantry sections with the medical supplies. It's, especially in 1v1, not really worth it to go for the artillery upgrade. And we see that Hector has picked his commander as well. Advanced Emplacement Regiment will be the choice. I think that's a good choice. He might be going for mortar pits. He's probably going for mortar pits. And that will be really good against all these HMGs. We'll see where he places it, if he builds it. First scout car is in the queue, and as I said, quick tag up from Zerg, as I expected. Probably double scout car. Hector has pushed in pretty heavily over here. Probably buying time for his Vickers to set up. He will have to retreat those two units. Flank coming in from the Pioneers, already upgraded with the mine detector package, which is good. Will be very useful for spotting mines, of course. Scout car might give a chase, no mines on the retrieve path. And Hector chooses for a AT gun and is building his first mortar pit in a very strategic position. I'm curious how far this will come with shooting. It's gonna be interesting. Second scout car has arrived on the field. It's good that Hector is going for the AT gun, even though it will cost him some map control in the early stage of the game. He is going to need something to protect his mortar pits. And he still has his fuel and the left victory point, so he won't drain much VPs. Let's see how this works out. Mortar pit is ready. Can we see his range? I don't know if we can. We'll have to find out. Barbed wire on the right side. All the green cover is wired off. Very good. And the first Panzer Grenadier is coming out for Zerg. Why would Zerg pick this commander straight away? Because probably one of the most important things is the Jaeger Light Infantry upgrade, the G43s. But he's not going for Grenadiers, and well, G43s on Panzer Grenadiers, I don't know if that's worth it. The camouflage will be interesting to see if he utilizes it. You can upgrade it for only 30 munition. Nice MG placements over here. Vickers has to get out of there. Let's get suppressed. This infantry squad has to watch out as well. Mortar pit is starting to do its job. Oh god. Only one model left. Where's our Etigan? Etigan is on the left. We'll be moving back to the middle to protect the mortar pit, probably. Another Etigan coming from Hector. Good choice. Because of the double scout car, and one Etigan won't do the job. And you can also see that Zerg is, well, expecting an ASC to come out, and I don't think it will come with the second Etigan being built. But he already upgraded the Panzer Strikes now, so the Panzer Grenadiers will be less effective against the infantry. We've got ambush camouflage being upgraded. That's gonna be cool to see. That's good. He just lets the Panzer Grenadiers stay over here for recon. Let's have a look. You see now he can see this point, and the enemy Hector in this case won't be able to see him if he stands over here. And the Panzer Strike will be able to surprise any vehicle that's coming up over here. Only problem is that Hector is not making any vehicles. This pioneer can almost build a mine over here. Let's see if he does it. No, he's going for the removal package. He's going to wire it up. A mine here would be good, I think. Or maybe here. When Hector tries to push up. How's this mortar pit doing? Zero kills, yeah, but it was irritating, this MG42. We've got incendiary rounds being popped. Oh, this will do some nasty damage over here. Panzer Grenadiers have been discovered. Maybe a bundle grenade on the Vickers. No, not enough. Oh, not enough munitions. Nice usage of the camouflage here. Hector couldn't see the... Oh, scout car goes down because the double AT gun hadn't been spotted yet by Zerg. Scout cars are down now. Oh! What was that? The bundle grenade, I think? Panzer Grenadier and Vickers will both get out, probably. An AT gun being built by Zerg. Might be a mistake. He could... Well, although, it might even be good, because he can expect an early Cromwell from Hector. Because we've already got the company command post being upgraded. Well, already has been upgraded. But, as I said, nice usage of the camouflage, because Hector couldn't see the MG over there in cover. Was a nasty surprise over here. Here another ancient view. Vickers will be caught out by it. That's good uses of the camouflage. Another Panzer Grenadier in the queue for Zerg. Flank coming in from Zerg on the retreat. Won't get the Vickers though. We've got the improved fortification upgrades, increases armor and health. That's good. The mortar putt will be able to do his job with no mortars from the austere to try and bombard the enemy mortar. And already that one. Smoke barrage, what it gets, experienced crew, reduces the time and threat 2. Better prepare the emplacement into a stronger defensive position. Okay. The double AT guns did their job, they protected the mortar pit from the offensive scout cars. Already one down, and one scout car won't do the job. A few cash from Zerg, yeah, both players have around 400 manpower. Hector is coming in a triple cap now, he will have to push the left side, because otherwise he won't make it to the late game. It's good to see though that Hector is not going for another emplacement, either upgrading a Beaufort or making another mortar pit, because in 1v1 it's just not worth it to make, well, more than one emplacements, to be honest. It's just a lot of manpower that you can use on other useful units as well. It's not I think nobody would recommend building more than one emplacement in 1v1 games. You've got the mortar pit probably going to open fire over here. Fixus is doing some nasty damage on the FAT2 HMG. Panzer Grenadiers are also upgraded with the ambush camouflage. Maybe we are going to see an... yes, Blunder Grenade is coming in. Hector will have to retreat. He's not seeing it. Oh, squad wipe. Ah, he might get another squad wipe. Vickers. Ah, oh, yes, Vickers is down. Do we have something to protect the Vickers? Oh, that's nice. The infantry section gets one model down on the Panzer Grenadiers, which means the Panzer Grenadier won't be able to take the figures, and now Hector has kept the left TP and got his figures back. But that infantry section, because he only had two infantry sections, is a heavy bleed for Hector. We've got a Cromwell on the queue though, and Panzer 4. Already a tag up to the support armor corps. The AT gun that I earlier saw has been cancelled, I didn't see that. Two AT guns are moving to the left to try and maybe take down that scout car. Those two AT guns will also be good against the P4 that's coming. You've got engineers coming now, that's good. No upgrade for either the weapon racks or the extra infantry squads. That's a late retreat from Hector. Gets away though, that's lucky. What's his ability? That's infantry awareness, has been called. An engineer unit is ready for action. Won't help him out though. A nice FAT2 MG over here. Cromwell will do some good damage against it though, but he can't see it yet. It has been revealed now. We'll have to retreat that. Yes, it's retreating straight away. P4 and Panzer Strikes are coming to the left. Can he get the kill on this HMG? No, he can't. Will he chase? He probably shouldn't, and he's not. He has to watch out for defensive mines. Hector also has a lot of munition. I would recommend getting... oh, 5-man squads. There we go. And the weapon rack. Good that he's upgrading the weapon rack. P4 will have to move in now. Again, an HMG in cover has been good uses of the cover from the ambush cover. Hector can't see if there's any MG near a point. We'll have to back out this Cromwell now. P4 has been doing some good damage. AT guns are moving in. Smoke to cover the engineers on retrieve, I guess. Yes, weapon reps are being upgraded now. Probably mean that our infantry sections will get some how are they called? Light machine guns. They will deal some good damage against these Panzer Grenadiers on long range. Etigans are moving in. Can't see these Panzer Grenadiers who can throw a Bundle Grenade. Oh, Scout Car. First shot is off. Won't be a second shot. Panzer Grenadiers are revealed, even though one of them is still on hold fire. Vickers, nice coverage. Nice cover from the Vickers. Etigans can get out now. HMG moving up. Still no sign of Hector pushing the right side, but he doesn't have much squads to push the right side, so yeah. I guess that's understandable. P4 might get a nasty flank off on this Cromwell over here. Let's have a look. Rear armor hits are coming in. Will it get the last shot off? Etigans are moving in from Hector. No attack round has been called. P4 and Cromwell will get away. Vickers pushes back this Vet 2 and G. SMG is doing nothing. Finally, healing coming down. Well, I'm thinking about it now. Zerga has a lot of munition for the artillery barrage, but especially for the stupid close air support. But he didn't need the healing because, well, HMGs. The healing on HMGs is not very important, and the HMGs were pretty good on health. Again, this HMG will probably. No, it's just outside of the range, the Vickers. But yeah, there were only the two Panzer Grenadier squads who would need it to heal, so it was not worth it to spend manpower on it, although I've seen Zerg float some manpower ammunition. So, well, now the healing is there. I don't think it was really necessary to get the healing earlier, but it is necessary to get the healing now. If he went Grenadiers, of course, he would have. Well, he probably would have made the healing earlier, which is a good idea. We just saw the scout car standing over here with the infantry awareness. Means all the infantry was revealed that was near, or all the infantry. No, that was near him. So he probably has spotted this Vickers. There's nothing Zerg can do about that irritating mortar, but MG will have to get out of there. Cromwell's pushing in. We've got, as I said, the light guns, or the light MG. Wow, what are they called? The British Allen light and machine guns on the engineers. And finally, Hector is getting some infantry. P4 might go down here. Nice usage of the artillery barrage. Might kill at least one of the Etigans. He's walking back into it. Bad idea. And yes, one of the Etigans goes down. Will, however, be recruited as the Cromwell here is ready to protect the last Etigan. HMG should get out of there. No, it's actually moving back in. That's not a good idea. You should get it healed first. The second P4 is on the field. Maybe we are going to see a Firefly or another Cromwell. I think another Cromwell. Yeah, the HMG is going down. It was a bad idea. Oh, Cromwell is squeezing in way too deep with the Panzer Tracks and the P4 here. Oh, the building was so low that it actually got both MG and upgraded Panzer Tracks squad. Etigan has been picked up, will do some damage. Good micro from Hector here is moving around on the other side. Zerg has to watch out that he is not moving in. Oh, direct hit from the artillery barrage. Etigan again has been lost. If Zerg would have placed the telemine over here in the beginning, the Cromwell would have been down now. Etigan is covering the retreat of the Cromwell. We've got finally enough infantry squad, well, some infantry squads from Hector, which means he will be able to get some map control back. And we see actually with the loss of the upgraded Panzer Grenadier and HMG. That Zerg has a bit of manpower problems. He lost, well, he doesn't have a lot of inventory. Second Panzer Grenadier is now coming back. He needs to repair his he needs to repair his Panzer Force, and finally the ambushed MGs in the middle have been pushed out, which means Hector can push in. A lot of fuel caches on the right will provide him with more early, more fuel in the early and mid stage of the game, which will give him a big advantage. But the loss of that HMG and Panzer Grenadier costs a lot of manpower drain. So I guess Zerg wished he would have built one fuel cache less, so he could provide, well, he could make another P4 or another Grenadier or Panzer Grenadier. Vickers is moving away, might get Thunder Grenade here. No, not enough munition yet. Vickers won't suppress the Panzer Grenadier Scott, we'll have to retreat. Yeah, there we go. Nice uses of the trench over here. And Hector is finally pushing up the right as well. He finally has the infantry squads to do it. And again, good that Hector isn't making more emplacements or mortar pits, because he wouldn't have been able to get more infantry squads, which are necessary for him to push up and gain more map control. And he would probably, if he laid a mortar pit, too offensive. And that's what I like as well. He laid the mortar pit over there as a defense, and it was nice to cover this area. But if he would have laid it over here or something in the open, the scout cars would have just been able to rush in, get one of the AT guns, because at that moment there was still only one AT gun, and the upgraded Panzer Grenadiers that were lost on this building would have probably killed the mortar pit if it was built over here. Lol. But yeah, that's good. He built it over here, made two AT guns to protect its protect its mortar pits, and not building another mortar pit has gained him more map control actually, because he could build those infantry squads. Hector wanted to make a mine over here, has been caught out by the ambush camouflaged HMG. Cornwall needs to watch out for this double P4 over here. Again, the infantry awareness, so Zerg knows that the Vickers is over here. Nice usage of the trench on the right. Will Hector has upgraded the hammer tactics, so we will probably see a comet soon, saving manpower for it. I'm wondering, where did the second AT gun go to? I think it has been, oh yeah, there it is, it has been destroyed by the artillery barrage on the 20 munition. I'm curious. I would say Hector has now the better army, of course. More infantry squads to push, and I think the AT gun and Cromwell will be able to deal with the double P4s if he plays it right, and maybe lays another mine over here if the P4s decide to push up for the mortar pit. Nice camouflaged Panzer Grenadiers here. Might want to put them over here. Yeah, there we go. Mortar pit is raining down his shells again. These Panzer Grenadiers over here are pretty useless. There you go, Fixer setting up. Panzer Grenadiers might move in now for the Thunder Grenades. Will be caught out now by the infantry squad. There you go, Thunder Grenades coming in. Will wipe, I think. Oh no, it's the Vet 2 stays alive. There's the second AT gun. And the Comet is on the queue for Hector. We need P4s on the left. P4s are pushing in actually. No, they decide to back off, that's good. G has been called out over here by a nice flank from Hector with the sappers. And Hector is getting his double munition back. Oh no, Zerg is getting his munition back. Hector had double munition. Will his Fat 2 MG go down? Will be a heavy loss of veterans. Oh, Hector drops LMG gun. I don't know. Yeah, that's gonna be probably for the Panzer Grenadiers. Will be nice. Fair 2 Vickers is covering over here. Again, Zerg is going to use. Yeah, there we go. Infantry awareness. Good. You will see the Vickers in the middle. But here we have the OP comment. Let's see what that will do. P4s might be pushing on the right. Let's see what they are going to do. No mines ahead of them. Comet. Comet is moving to the right, as well as the Cromwell. This might be a nice battle over here incoming. He's going to destroy the trench, which means the Cromwell and Comet and the upcoming AT guns know that the two P4s are here. Trench is down. Comet is going to shoot. No, it's going to back off. And now we'll go in. Rear armor has been exposed from Zerg. Comet, Cromwell and the two AT guns are slowly pushing up, but the P4s are backing off. Triple cap from Hector actually will mean that Zerg is going to have less VPs than Hector soon. HMG won't survive the, well, we'll have to retreat, we'll get pinned soon. And we see that Zerg probably knows those two AT guns are here. Cromwell is going to push. Seize the scout car. Scout car needs to get out of there. Will die though. Scout car down. P4s are moving in on the left. Might want to go for the mortar now. We've got a Panzer coming up with a heavy Panzer Corps being built. Yeah, there we go. P4s are moving in for the mortar. Mortar has the extra health though. And Veteran C2, which will mean it will be a little bit more difficult to destroy. Brace will soon be called off. Yeah, there we go. If Hector had laid a mine over here, the P4s would have been caught out now. We've got AT guns going to the left. Bundle grenade that didn't do much. P4s will have to back out again. This is a dangerous place because Hector could have laid mines. Grenade. Sepus is going down. Nice grenade from the Panzer Grenadiers. Hector has enough to make another Cromwell. He doesn't know about the Panther yet though. Panther is going to be good against this. Where is it? It's Comet that's driving in the mid. Still a triple cap from Hector there. But the two AT guns that Hector has were and still are a pretty good choice because they protected the mortar pits and now do heavy damage versus both Panther and P4s. Comet is moving in. Cromwell is moving in. Is this the push? P4 gets out. Panther and Panzer 4 are moving in. Panther misses his first shot. Cromwell and Comet are focusing the P4. Will the Panther chase for the Cromwell if it hits? No, it hits. Tries to hit the Comet, but misses. Two AT guns here. Again, good positioning from Hector. The Panther and P4 aren't able to chase because of the two AT guns. P4 needs to watch out, low on health. We've got engineers who need to repair that bounce from the AT gun on the Panther. Panther has, of course, good armor, another bounce. And we've got precision barrage being used. Where? On the HMG on the left. How much is it? 200 manpower or munition to take out one MG. I don't know if that's worth it, but it was probably pretty irritating for Hector because of the ambush camouflage. So this will be a heavy mental win for Hector, and we've got the side skirts on the P4 now. It's fair too, we'll do some good damage against the infantry squads. Comets is doing its job. We've got a Firefly coming, good idea against the Panther on long range. Although Hector already has the two AT guns, so a comet might have been a better choice. But both, the Firefly will do good damage against those P4s and Panther, so it's never a bad choice. I wouldn't make a Firefly as the first tank you get out as a bridge force, but this is the third tank, so it might be worth it. Mortar Pit is still alive because of the good placement over here and the AT guns that would, well, that are scaring away the P4s. I lack the mines though that Hector didn't place, but Zerg didn't place the mines as well. Panther misses again. I don't think the Panther, as you can see, it almost has no experience, which means he doesn't, well, he hasn't hit anything yet. And I've seen him, the Panther, miss 3 shots. He should probably hold it still and not let it fire on the move. Needs to back off again because the Comet penetrates. Comet is moving in. Again, the fourth shot that Panther misses. Nice usage of the phosphorus shell. The infantry squad might be able to pick that. Ooh, Vetri MG survives. No longer a triple cap against Zerg as well. Firefly with teleport rockets is ready to get those P4s on the right. And Hector didn't have much map control in the early game, but finally got, because of good plays, good defensive play, he took it easy on, knew what he had to do, and now has enough infantry and tanks to push up and get more map control. This Panzer Grenadier should be on hot fire. If the Comet hits, up, oh, phosphorus shell coming in. P4s are coming in, that's 2 P4 coming in, Panther's coming in, Panther is already down. Firefly, AT guns and Comet got it. P4 will need to back out, bounces on the Comet. Teleprox is being used, Vet 1 P4 is stunned. The Vet 2 P4 is going for the flank, but will get killed because of rear armor hits. Comet bounces, Cromwell bounces, but the AT gun in the back gets it. Vet 1 gets a nice rear armor hit on the Vet 3, actually Comet now, 20 kills, but dies as well, and this is going to be GG. The hell was I playing? Well, Zerg had the early advantage, but he had a good early game, but that was because the British early game, of course, is pretty shit. But Hector knew what he had to do. He knew he shouldn't be over pushing. He just held on to his fuel and victory point. Nice defensive play of the mortar pits. Not offensive, which, if he played offensive, we would probably have lost that mortar pits. The Etigans were there to cover his mortar pits, and even though it cost him the early game, you have seen that it did some, well, it protected the mortar pits and it did good damage in the mid and late game because the P4s couldn't really push up because of the two AT guns that were constantly there. And because of Hector not going in for full emplacements, which you should never do in 1v1, he was able to get some more infantry squads out in the end, which gave him a lot of map control. Zerg, he had a nice early game, really nice usage of the ambush cannon flash on the HMGs, because Hector was caught out by it, I think a few times, a lot of times actually. And the Panzer Grenadiers could get off some nice bundle grenades. But in the end, the defensive play, although Hector could have laid some more mines as well as Zerg, but the defensive play, good multi-pit placements, The chilling, the relaxing play of Hector, the relaxing strategy, not overreacting, not pushing in too far, not setting this, putting this mortar pit too far at the battlefront, and overextending with his early game, and that brought Hector the win against Zerg. Nice game, GG. I hope you guys enjoyed, and maybe see you guys next time. Bye bye.